Welcome guys to another episode of Boom Arena. Today we're gonna be playing with a Super Ape Bomb Skeleton deck, which is very old school deck to be said, but I think it's gonna be pretty relevant even in this meta. With Viking, I think it's a bit weaker than usually, and my opponent just straight up goes for... I don't know what to say, I'm out of words, and it's already 30 seconds into the video, so I'm gonna just snipe this mortar pretty much, go for the Bomb Skeleton Super Ape at the opposite hand side, because he just went too aggressive, and unfortunately my plan didn't work out. I wanted to catch his swordsman with my skeletons, and yeah, it didn't work out, but the thought was there. And I'm gonna be having just a very comfortable damage advantage, because he just went very aggressively against my first play Bomb Skeleton, and it just wasn't it, bro. If you're threatening me with that much mana at the bridge, you have to make sure that your push can at least take the tower down. And here he plays fifth to block my Bomb Skeleton, which obviously won't be good, because he's gonna still receive a lot of damage, but at least he won't be losing a tower, so that's a good thing for him. I'm gonna play EQ here against this mortar, and this Bomb Skeleton will reach a tower, so that's gonna be a very good opening in this game number one. He's going to play another digger, as he can pretty much still rely on the digger chip. No, mate, now you need a comeback, and if you don't make some big moves, like at the start of the game, it wasn't time for risking everything for the biscuit. Right now it certainly is, because if you don't do anything, I'm gonna straight up just walk over you and destroy you. So I'm gonna just take this tower here. Unfortunately though, he's gonna be taking out my gunner with a poison, which is like the most frustrating thing in the world, especially when your gunner didn't do anything special yet. So I'm gonna just place Rolling Steel, hoping to kill this. Okay, I'll have to add something else. And yeah, he left the game. We're gonna leave on that mark and hop to the next game of the video. And we're in the game number 2 against Bongo. So he will have 420 medals, which is apparently pretty easy amount to accumulate, since I've never played against this player, and he already has 420 medals, so pretty bizarre to see, but nonetheless we're gonna be playing some video games against him, and I'm gonna actually play Bomb Skeleton, because why not, we might as well. And he's gonna be playing Runners, which is interesting pick by itself. I think we're gonna have a little stalemate here at the bridge, which is, well, I wouldn't say perfect for us, but at the same time it's not bad or something. So I'm gonna play Fontaine here, stop this gunner from getting any hits, and we're in a slight damage deficit, but it doesn't really matter at this point. We still want to figure out what he's playing, this kind of stuff. He's gonna be playing Cannon against a Super Ape. Mind you that Cannon is pretty much the best response that there is to Super Ace, so that's gonna be interesting to say the least. He's gonna also be playing with Runners. We still have to take that into account, so I cannot go for the Super Ape right now, nor Bomb Skeleton for that matter, but I can pretty much go for a Super Ape on the opposite side. So now he has to decide which side he wants to defend, and as I expected, he will ignore Gunner, and that's gonna be a damage, sir. I'm gonna play right now Rolling Steel here, because I don't want to receive too much damage from the Runners, and I think that kinda could have been a mistake, because like this Fawn Horde dealt a lot of damage, so probably Rolling Steel should have been used on the opposite side. Either way, I think we are still fine. We are, well, almost 1000 damage behind. That's actually not fine. He's having Apes, so that's a very reliable win condition for him to get damage. So yeah, now I'm analyzing situation. I'm not liking it too much. I'm gonna play Cannon nonetheless, because yeah, that's pretty much the best play in the position still. We're gonna play some skeletons here, and the gunner gets a hit, because Bomb Skeleton is absolutely walking douche. And yeah, I'm gonna be playing second Bomb Skeleton, because this deck has very quick cycle. I'm gonna play Gunner to kill this Cannon, and right now I'm gonna just kinda hope that my two Bomb Skeletons will do something, because it's just looking scary, and I'm not gonna spoil anything, but yeah, it's looking very scary for him. I think these Bomb Skeletons will just connect to the tower, and he knows that. Oh, I'm very happy to see that, because he was just playing very greedy for the entire game, and finally, when dust settles, it just bombs skeletons all over the place. And yeah, very fun game against him. He kind of BMs me at the end, which is kind of off-putting, because I enjoyed this game. I hoped he enjoyed this game as well, because he was playing very creative deck. I actually liked this deck out of him, even though it had runners, because also he has Apes EQ, which is like more of a stable in condition. So yeah, very cool to see. GG's to Bongo, and we're gonna go for the game number 3. And it looks like we're gonna get a Bongo again, so obviously we will leave the nice play and cycle skeletons, even though he has runners, and skeletons are by far the best response to that card in our deck. I think it's okay to cycle it first play. I think he's just waiting for us to make the first move, so we're gonna just play Gunner. There's no reason not to. He's playing Footman Hut, which is already a very interesting move. I will say I want to protect that Gunner, so we're gonna be playing Bomb Skeleton on that. And we're gonna start our mini push with Bomb Skeleton. So when I see Digger and a Footman Hut and a Steel Hammer, I honestly don't know what deck it could be. But I'm gonna be playing Super Ape and Fire Tiny, just predicting his potential swarm response. And if it's not gonna be a swarm, it's gonna be a drunker. And unfortunately, he put it in an incorrect spot, because I'm gonna still get one hit. He's going very aggressive with that. I'm not a fan of that, because I can just play spells on that. Although his footman gets some juicy hits, so I'm gonna just drop a nice play. Obviously, playing EQ right away would be way better play than playing Roaring Steel first, but it is what it is. And I think all in all, he tried to surprise us, but now the surprise part is over and he'll have to outplay us in a macro game where we have the full information. So, big question obviously is what spell he has, and my call will be that he has freeze looking at this deck right now, but obviously it still can be anything because we haven't revealed that yet. I'm gonna be playing a Super Ape here, so that's gonna be a one hit for us in the books. And also Bomb Skeleton will all get a lot of value because of this big black bomb. And we're gonna get some also bigger chip, which is very, very out of place. Never have I ever seen a Digger and Cemetery paired and working. So obviously Bongo has the opportunity to present me with another reality. This Super Ape will connect to the tower and get some important hits. I'm gonna clean up all these footmen with a very nice timed holy fuck. Oh my, okay. I should have just used EQ. Like I said, I'm sometimes try to be too greedy for my own good, and right now I'm in a very tricky spot, because actually, now I think about it, he has a very decent matchup against me, because, oh, he has even Cyclones, so that's gonna be even worse. So I'm gonna be trying to clean up everything with that, and right now we're just in a very scary spot, because we will have to defend the cemetery pretty much perfectly, and if we don't, we're gonna be in a bit of a pickle. So that's gonna be a defense that I hope we want to see. Right now we're gonna just play this and that, hope for him to play some responses, and he's actually on top of his responses. That's gonna be a very scary thing for him to defend, because Super Ape gets a hit, but that's gonna be also okay. I'm not sure if I'm a fan of that. I'm gonna try to defend this cemetery properly. He's gonna use a cyclone, get even 2 splash damages, and unfortunately that's gonna be an L. So very well played out of him. I kinda was playing with my foot, should have ended this game a bit sooner. And yeah, like I said, too greedy with EQ. Obviously, when skeletons accumulate on your tower, you definitely should take them out. So yeah, GG is for Bongo. He actually has a very decent deck. Wonder why didn't he use it in the game number 1. But yeah, that's gonna be the win in the books for him. And we're gonna jump to the game number 4. And right now we're against a guy called Toads Rule, who apparently is a huge fan of toads, which I don't blame him because toads are absolutely cool animals. And his nickname shows up. Gotta respect that. I'm gonna play Super Ape because he was aggressive recently, so I just gotta respond in some way, shape or form. And yeah, I'm gonna just be playing Bomb Skeleton here to respond to both threats. Fortunately, Fifth is very quick, so that's gonna be a... that's gonna actually benefit my defense because I will be able to kite both of these things with Bomb Skeleton. And I'm gonna clean up archers. Like, all in all, I think we can call it a perfect opening because we've... okay. That's not gonna be the perfect opening for sure, because yeah, I'm gonna just receive some damage. And even though I could have prevented that, I thought of being greedy once again, and once again it doesn't just pay off. I'm gonna play Bomb Skeleton here to kite the Thief once again. And this time I think... oh, this time he's gonna be playing Skeleton Horde, so that's gonna be the thing that's gonna be a worry. But what I was about to say, that this Bomb Skeleton was about to enter the bridge too early, so the tower won't be engaging the steel hammer with Bomb Skeleton, and that's usually considered bad. You usually want to engage your enemy within your tower range, so your troops on defense will have more hit points to counterattack. And that was basically the premise of this potential defense that didn't work out as a planned, for actually two reasons. Because first of all, the initial Bomb Skeleton placement was too high, and second of all, he played the Skeleton Horde, so that's why it didn't work out. I'm gonna play another Bomb Skeleton. So far, nothing too surprising. I'm gonna right now go with my Super Ape. So far he doesn't have a good response against this Fire Tiny, so I'm gonna just abuse it to the absolute limits. Go for Rolling Steel here, and right now he is just within one Super Ape hit and any spell. So Super Ape still does 3-3-3 damage, very cool, very easy to remember, and that's why I'm gonna go for a Super Ape. He plays Missile and absolutely misses my Gunner. I'm not sure if he targeted my tower, but he definitely missed my Gunner because she's still alive. And with that being said, I think we are just closing the game on a good note. So yeah, that was some weird deck out of Toad's rule, but yeah, obviously saying GG at the end is kinda mandatory if we want to maintain our reputation, and that's why we leave it here. So yeah, let's jump just to the game number 5 and wrap this video up. And in the last game of this video, we're gonna get a 6-star player. So he's gonna be going with Digger and Fawn's first play. Mind you that it's still the thing that people go first play and expect things to work out. It kinda did, because it was pretty much the opening play. I'm gonna play Cannon against these archers and Bone Blasters. Hope to get very clean defense, and the clean defense I did get, so yeah. My Bomb Skeleton will walk up the ramp, still will wait for him to respond, and okay, I'm gonna just follow it up with Super Ape. That's a very annoying combo for him to deal with. He places a very long distance kite bomb tower in order to get the most value out of the building, but unfortunately, he was supposed to be playing it way closer. He's tanking for this one, Fawn, which is just not comfortable for me. And yeah, he wanted to get the most value of his bomb tower, and he didn't because of my Super Ape that folded up. Right now I'm gonna just be Super Ape, force his bomb tower, and now I kinda know that he's down 2 mana, so I can do many things with that, but I will probably just translate it into a Bomb Skeleton in the back, so I can just make a bigger push and try to go for some timing. And he's playing Bone Blaster, so right now my mana advantage has been reduced to 1. Very nice play for him. And I'm gonna just play Bomb Skeleton anyway, because okay, it looks like I mis-evaluated that. I actually have 1 mana advantage. I'm gonna play Rolling Steel here. That's gonna be actually increasing my advantage, but he got some tower damage in a process. So I'm gonna be playing Fire Tiny here, and instantly Super Ape, trying to get something done. I'm gonna play some EQ against this bomb tower, hopefully get something done. Obviously the bomb will clean up everything, and that was absolutely perfect. I'm gonna be playing some skeletons against that. He won't be playing poison, and I was very smart out of him. And right now I'm gonna just go for fire tiny. Hope he will play something big. And he actually misses rolling still, so that's gonna be obviously very bad for him, because you don't want to like waste 2 mana like this and take damage. So I'm gonna try to snipe his bomb tower, and he's very quick with a response to that. My Super Ape won't break through, unfortunately. At the same time, we're just getting spell damage ever so slightly every time. That's absolutely fine. I'm gonna block these bomb blasters with my cannon, and right now I'm gonna just go for another Super Ape. Gonna try to break through. At least I'm gonna just get EQ damage, which is always fine. I'm gonna go for skeletons. I'm gonna go for bomb skeleton. Clog the bridge. No shenanigans have been happening. This digger will be very nicely countered by our skeletons. Getting 2 hits. I expected 1. Eh, whatever. I'm gonna play EQ right now. He's gonna be playing actually bomb tower in anti-EQ spot, which is very well known. I'm gonna be playing a cannon here, which surprisingly will kite both of the bomb blasters. I kinda was already ready to play my my skeletons, but I fortunately could have saved them for another time. So I'm gonna just play Gunner here. I'm gonna play now Super Ape, because it's pretty much go time. Now we're just about to get the last damage of the game, and I'm absolutely going for it. So he's gonna be playing Digger on the tower, but it doesn't matter. Super Ape connects, EQ connects, and that's gonna be GG, well played in the last game of this video. So, Bomb Skeleton, Super Ape, pretty unfortunate that I didn't get any Viking Bridge Spam games today, so I could like show you how to play this matchup, because it's pretty different from the Swordsman one. The Swordsman is more of a flexible and I would say solid option, but a Bomb Skeleton can deal with like... can scale better in the double mana time, because it's basically harder to kill, and if you can keep your opponent's troops in the bomb of Bomb Skeleton, you'll be most likely fine. So yeah, that's gonna be it from me today. If you enjoyed the Boom Arena content from me and from other creators, because yeah, I would love to say that Boom Arena content is booming, but it's unfortunately not. There are only a couple of creators. But anyway, if you enjoy the Boom Arena content, absolutely consider subscribing to my YouTube channel if you aren't already. And with that out of the way, I'm gonna see you guys in the next episode of Boom Arena.